we're encouraged to negate every kind of disappointment in our lives. We're told that fear and pain and all those things are things that we can overcome or avoid, or kind of, you know, if we're in touch with this kind of spiritual life, we won't ever have those things in our lives. And of course, I think they're terribly important. I think the pain and the disappointments and all that are so much a foundation of making us stronger as people, that I think we have to embrace them as much as we embrace happiness or the need for happiness and all that. Maybe I do dwell on those aspects of life quite a lot in my albums. They are darker, they are kind of... I'm not really that kind of guy at all, though. I'm not Trent. I'm not that serious. I'm not that dark all the time. I'm actually quite a buoyant personality. But I think left to my own devices, that 2 a.m. moment in the early morning, all these questions and all that questioning comes into play. When I'm writing, I really, it's a different part of me that I kind of reach into, and a lot of it is inevitably about the construction of our lives and why we create values and what is morality, and are all these just kind of, are they self-structures that we create to give ourselves a reason for living? I mean, is the reality that there is no morality? Which is kind of scary, because that means there's no reason for life, in which case, why do we bother? Oh, I hate that. Oh, I don't want to go there. You know, but you do. You keep confronting that all the time. I do, anyway.